It has been said that the difference between a novice and a craftsman is the fact that the craftsman can hide his mistakes. We don't hide any mistakes around here, and I'm going to talk to you about one right now. Now, we ordered this brake line kit from National Parts Depot. It came in, and it is beautiful. It is for a 78 Ford truck with disc brakes, but we have a 72. And apparently between 1967 and 1979, when they ceased production on this particular type of truck, Ford changed the brake lines about 784 bajillion times. Okay, it's not that many, but it's a lot. If you go to their catalog, there are several kits available. Short box, long box, drum brakes, disc brakes. And we thought the 78 kit would be the one that would solve our problem and allow us to use a stock proportioning valve. That's not going to be the case. Well, if you're watching this, there's a better than fighting chance that you have an F-100 of your own and you're looking for parts. But our parts watching pretty much stopped when we started working with National Parts Depot. The cool thing about NPD is these guys have the parts in stock and available from one of their four convenient locations across the United States. National Parts Depot has a location in Ocala, Florida, another location in Charlotte, North Carolina, still another in Detroit, Michigan, and a location in Ventura, California. And they have phone lines that are manned 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, nearly 365 days a year. If you don't want to talk to a human being, that's fine too. They have a website that has all the parts listed on it, and you can order them from there and get those parts, just like with a phone call, within 3 to 4 business days from one of those four locations. We've worked with this enthusiast-owned company for over 20 years. They're who helps us get things done around here at Auto Restomod. Give them a call. Give them a try. We think you'll like the experience. All right, that's just a quick flash on how to put together the discs on these trucks. If you want to see the full video, there's a link right here. Just basically type that into the search box, bada bing, bada boom. You'll get right to the video. Then also, there is a link in the description below. If you want to click that link, you can do that as well. Another thing I want to talk about real quickly is the fact that we had some guys write in with some problems that they saw with what we did. Several guys wrote in saying, why didn't you paint the beams? Well, the reason I didn't paint the beams is this truck's a pig, an absolute pig, and I don't mean that in a bad way. It's just not a great, super high-end truck. It sees road duty in the rain, things get nasty, and it has enough oil leaks coming off the FE to probably be a slight member of the Exxon Valdez Club. So I'm not that worried about what the beams look like on this. One of the guys wrote in and said we should be showing us wearing safety glasses, and we should have had safety glasses on working on the vehicle last week. When I was doing the work on taking the shock off and I had a swivel on there, those swivels, when they're being impacted, can come apart. If you're not using the right kind of swivel, like the one I'm showing you here, you can blow that thing apart. You need to wear the safety glasses because there's crap falling down on your face while you're working underneath the trucks. That's going to be happening to us a lot today because we're doing a master cylinder in preparation for putting this pig back on the street, and next week showing you exactly how it drives with all the new front end components. On it! All right, what I wanted to talk about real quickly here is the tires that are on here. Now these are fairly new. We have almost no miles on them, yet I'm already starting to get cupping. If you'll take your tire and when you pull it off and you'll run your hand backward across the tire, either on the outside or the inside edge. This inside edge is nice and smooth. There's no feathering to it. You can feel the feather by running your hand backwards on the tire. Problem with the F-100, and it's a problem I hope to solve real soon. I have found a set of later model F-150 wheels that we're going to put on this thing to get rid of these spacers so we can rotate the tires on this thing, because that is an issue on these trucks that I hope to get rid of. All right, what Cam's doing back there is he's actually pulling a vacuum to the furthest point on the braking system so we could just pull all the fluid out of the master cylinder. It makes things a lot easier and neater. So now you know. Easier to do that. Just take the brake fluid out through the back of the car, because you're going to have to go in and put brake fluid in it anyway when you put the new master cylinder on. All right, we're gonna trade this master cylinder out because if you'll see, there's some rust down there in the bottom. That's not good. That means we have a leak somewhere, probably in the piston assembly on this one. This one would probably work for a dual res because it is a small bowl, large bowl system. This is the bowl for your front brakes with your disc or drum. This is the bowl for your rear brakes. I know it's opposite of what you might think, but that's how it goes. So what we're going to be doing is trading it out for this one, a master cylinder from the guys at National Parts Depot. This is the correct master cylinder for disc brakes, even though I think the other one would probably work.
All right, I'm going to bench bleed the master cylinder. And the way you do that is you have to get little line fittings right like this that are made for bleeding. You can get them at most parts stores, or if you find a piece of brass that goes in there, you can make one yourself. You just want to have some clear lines so you can see air bubbles, and then you feed it back into the reservoir itself. We've got some fresh DOT-4. Go ahead and fill both reservoirs up about halfway. All right, and then I've got my scientific pushing tool, which is just an extension with a socket on it that fits inside the bore of the master cylinder piston. So, you just start by hand, slowly working it. And you'll see the air bubbles coming out of each line. And you keep doing this until the bubbles are no more.
All right, so we're going to go in and test our master cylinder. Always recommend you doing that. Cam's gonna go into it a little bit more, and I'm gonna be the guy who pushes the pedal.
All right, so we have the new master cylinder already bled on the bench, and we've got it mounted on our brake booster. So what you need to do is depress the pedal when you still have the lines on it, and you should get 3/8 to half an inch of movement before you see any fluid coming out. One second, let me remove the lines. Don't press it down fast.
Do or do not?
Do not.
Slow?
Yep. Go ahead.
Now you'll see we've got a little bit of lost motion on the pedal before we get down to where it actually depresses. This is pretty normal on a car with power brakes. And then we're on the master cylinder now.
All right, that's got fluid coming out.
Okay, so we've got fluid coming out, that's good. No fluid means you've got blocked lines, which means that the push rod is too far out. If it takes more than that initial, probably about an inch on your pedal to get your lines running in, you've got an issue. So we know we got a good master cylinder on here, but now we get to talk about the other things that I did absolutely wrong this week. Great day.
Okay.
Mistakes are good.
Yes, and I mean, it's an honest mistake. Yeah. You know, we really did try. I sat down and I reasoned it out, which that sometimes doesn't work real well for me.
Especially with cars.
Especially with cars, because things that should make sense don't.
Yes.
And Ford changed the brake lines and master cylinders on these trucks ad nauseum between 1960 and the steering, between 1967 and 79. And there's at least, we saw photographs today, and we started really looking at it. We looked
about 4 or 5 different ways the brake line, master cylinder, or steering gearbox to be configured.
It's just crazy, and I mean, I didn't think that was going to be the case, because I worked under the wacky assumption that Ford did things like General Motors, where they just left crap alone after they designed it.
Nah. Revisions.
It's everywhere. So, the problem we ran into, and why we stopped at the master cylinder, is the brake lines that I got in from National Parts Depot are not going to fit. It's not that they don't work, they would work wonderfully.
Mm-hmm.
They're just not going to work here. So what we're having to do is we're having to order a set of brake lines from National Parts Depot for a 72 long bed. We're going to be doing that next week. We'll be showing how to put the lines in. We're also going to be putting a proportioning valve that is a dial-style proportioning valve in the truck and showing you how to dial that in, hopefully. Because gosh
Don't
knows.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I'm already telling them what we're doing next week, too. That's a dangerous thing for me. Do me a favor, though. Leave a comment in the comment section below. We'd like to know what you think about what happened today. We are one show that is going to tell you, hey, we made a mistake, and we freely admit when it happens, because it happens. Whenever you're doing old cars and you're trying to reason things out and mash two different things together, sometimes they don't mash so well. Leave us something down in the comments below, or give us a thumbs up, or a thumbs down. And subscribe, because I want that stupid plaque. 100,000 people. That's it. We're 63 somewhere. We're 63,000 people. That's not much to ask in four or five. I know one of our camera guys said statistically that's impossible. Screw the statistics. You people can make it happen. If anybody can make anything happen, it's you guys. You guys go out and tell everybody you know. Go and subscribe to the channel. Tell the old lady at the grocery store. I want that stupid plaque. That's all I want. Exactly. Early. In any case, folks, that's our show for this week. You guys have a great week, and we'll see you next time on Auto Resto Mod. Take it off the jacks. Roll it in the yard.
Push it back.
Shut up.
Camera 3 is live.